So we're here today with Lisa Efros, who's running for Bloomfield Hills School Board. How are you today?
Good. How are you?
Good. Can you tell me what communities are in the Bloomfield Hills School District?
Bloomfield Hills School District pulls from 5 different municipalities. All of Bloomfield Hills, most of Bloomfield Township, a portion of West Bloomfield Township, Orchard Lake, and a portion of Troy.
And why have you decided to run?
I decided to run. I've been a parent for 16 years, a school district parent for 16 years. And I decided to run because I've noticed over the last couple of years some things that concern me a little bit in the district. And I think with my perspective and experience, I can make things better. And I like to jump in and help when I can.
Now, what are some of those issues that you want to tackle?
I would say for me and parents in the district, as well as probably students in the district, the number one concern is communications. The communications have been lacking altogether. Information is difficult to find. Information is disseminated late. And sometimes not clear, sometimes even with grammatical mistakes and typos.
Now, is there any other issues that are important to you that the school district is facing?
Lots of issues.
Tell me
but
some.
I'll try and be brief. I feel like one of my bigger issues is accountability on the part of the administration and on the part of the board. We have been historically very bad at seeking feedback, meaningful feedback from students, parents, and the community. And I think the level of dissatisfaction and the disconnect between policies, procedures, and what the district says they do and what they do in practice is causing a lot of questions and concerns amongst the community. I think we have an administrator who is the highest paid administrator in the state of Michigan, and a board that doesn't hold the administration accountable for any of the goals that they set. There is no way to measure progress except for an end of the year evaluation, but it is the superintendent who sets his own goals, measures his own goals, gives feedback on those goals to the board, and the board adapts them without having any real way of knowing whether he's accomplished or the district as a whole has accomplished any of those goals. So I would like to redefine some of the responsibilities of what it means to be a board member, involve the community more in providing feedback, and be able to give us a mechanism for fair evaluation of administration.
So can you tell us how you've been involved in the community and in the school district?
I have been a PTO president in the school district 7 different times. I have been involved in PTO and room parents since the day that my son started. So I lost count at 20 when one of the times involved a class that I had no children in. I've also been involved in community activities. I have coached softball teams and managed soccer teams, and I've also been on the board of Bloomfield Baseball, Bloomfield Youth Assistance, and a couple different district lobby and strategic planning groups. One of them, Bloomfield United, which was the advocacy group behind the support of building the new high school, and I was the treasurer. And I was also involved, have also been involved in some of the global education, diversity, and race relations, just to name a few, and closing the achievement gap strategic plan.
Now, from a professional perspective, what are some of the experience and skills that you would bring to this position?
I am an attorney. I'm actually a tax attorney. I also have an MBA and a master's in tax law. And I think that those that education will bring a lot. This is the first year that the district's Moody rating has gone down. Moody is a bond rating, and it really speaks to the reliability of an institution when money is lent for bond purposes. So it's troubling that the rating went down. I would like to know some of the factors involved in that, the reasons for that. And the other thing is I've seen copies of the budget, which are the same copies presented to the board. They're also made public and presented to anyone who attends a board meeting. They're very vague. The line items are not specific enough for me personally, as a potential board member, to be able to approve them. I would need a lot more specificity. I would need it to be reflected in the written budget so that I would be able to either approve or disapprove of it.
In this race, there are 7 people running for just a few positions. Why should people pick you?
I think people should pick me because they can trust me to speak honestly. I'm a direct person when I speak, when I write, and when I ask questions and demand accountability of others. I come prepared. I always do my homework. I come armed with facts, information, data, and I'm not afraid, nor will I back down if my opinion differs from everybody else on the board. My first and foremost consideration and top priority is the duty that I owe to the students in the school district. They come first. They always will. And to serve them best, I will sometimes ask the tough questions and demand answers.
People want more information about you and your campaign. Where do they go?
They can visit my website, lisaefrosforschoolboard.com. My web designing team is outstanding. I'm very proud of that website. I had nothing to do with the designing of it, so I can brag a little bit. It is sort of a go-to source. I do weekly, bi-weekly blog entries on anything from the state of education in this country, in the state, locally, and specifically in the Bloomfield Hills School District. I post interesting articles on school safety, depression and anxiety in high schoolers, early start times. That's just a few, but it's a really good go-to source for information on all things education.
Great. Well, thank you so much for coming out today.
Thank you.